it's components that are used for our automobiles, plastics, which are being created, right? All these are part of the chemical supply chain. In everything we buy, you know, it touches chemicals, touches steel, touches refining, and we've got to make sure that that continues to have a lower carbon footprint.
Another really important application and use for hydrogen is in the production of ammonia with nitrogen, hydrogen, and some processes you create ammonia. Now, ammonia is about 80% used in the fertilization industry. So in the food production world, the very important world of food production, getting more production out of our land to feed our people and to feed people around the world, fertilizers are critically important. Ammonia is critically important to that industry. So hydrogen has a real play there.
A lot of these heavy industries also require a lot of heating in their process, and they consume hydrocarbons for their heating value. So many of those industries are looking at how to replace, you know, natural gas or other kind of carbon, more carbon intensive fuels with hydrogen.
I think part of what, you know, the traditional industrial users have, whether that's cement or chemical refining, et cetera, is they have the assets they've built over decades. And those were very, had intense CO2 emissions. Their challenges are now trying to capture that CO2, clean it up, and sequester it, whether that's putting it into another chemical or putting it underground. And that's what they're really, you know, when we talk to our customers, they're coming to us asking if we have solutions in order to decrease their carbon emissions. And this is a key way, right? Capturing the CO2, providing hydrogen, clean hydrogen, as a fuel for them, certainly helps reduce those CO2 emissions.
You know, part of the challenge with hydrogen is not just the getting the production of hydrogen to the cost of producing green hydrogen to where it needs to be, but also the build out of the infrastructure needed to support that. Because at the end of the day, whether it's power or these heavy industries, you need reliable supply. That's important. It's not just cost, but reliability. And infrastructure has to be built out to enable that.
That's very expensive today, and many companies cannot adopt hydrogen in their processes because of the cost of the hydrogen and the availability, but it's not as easily available as it is off of a hydrogen reformer that uses natural gas, which is 24/7. You know, with renewable energy, you've got to worry about the time of day, because if there's no wind, or you go into the evening hours, into midnight where there is no sun, then how do you get the energy? So the energy needs to come from other sources. And so these are sorts of things that industry is struggling with to adopt hydrogen as a fuel or a feedstock into their process. A glass company, for instance, you can't shut them down. They shut down once every 20 years to reline their furnaces. And if they were to lose the hydrogen in the production of glass, they may have to shut the furnace down, which would cost them a lot of money. So these are the sorts of things that, you know, you have to get around and have to figure out, how do you ensure a low-cost, reliable supply of hydrogen in order to make industry feel comfortable in adopting it as a feedstock in their process?
I think there's a general awareness that lowering CO2 emissions is a good thing. I think there's also some companies that are able to move faster than others just based on their space that they're in. Really, it's coming from demand from consumers and shareholders that are asking for socially responsible carbon emission decreases. That's easier to do in some applications than others, and does become a cost issue, right? Because we all want affordable products. Capturing carbon and sequestering it has a financial cost to it. And so doing that economically and responsibly for these companies is also a challenge that they're working through. And they're trying to go after the easiest applications, the lowest cost applications first, and working through their systems as well.
I think we have a responsibility in the industry to educate consumers realistically about this journey we're on. I think that's really important. it helps set aggressive but realistic expectations. It sets different marks along the way for where we want it to be. Good companies will be looking forward and saying, where do we need to be in 5 to 10 years? Not just where do we need to be quarter to quarter. Sustainability matters now. It matters to your business. You simply won't have customers if you're not operating in an environmentally friendly way. So it's become part of business plans every day now. To show that you are doing sustainable gains and improvements in your business is now required, not just by your stockholders, but by your customers. So I think it's embedded in their business plans these days to be sure that whatever they're providing in products, they have the ability to show how they're contributing to this mission of decarbonization.
As a consumer, you're making choices about what you buy, right? As a consumer, you're also concerned about the environment and you're concerned about the next generation and the generation after that. And so the decisions that you make as a consumer today really are gonna help benefit later generations by placing your money with those companies that, you know, that are doing the right thing, stepping out today, making those changes in how they operate.
I mean, we are at the tip, very tip of a very big iceberg in terms of the potential of being able to use hydrogen for multiple applications.